The Browns combo, Jarvis Landry, David Njoku. Where do you think those guys are going? Jarvis Landry, David Njoku. Njoku we have as our 10th ranked tight end, mostly on the power of Jason's firm number six. And then Jarvis Landry, I've got him at 30.
I don't know what to do with him.
Him at 45 and 40. What's crazy about Landry is he actually had a very high market share of the offense last year. But then you mix in like a Baker Mayfield that was getting better and advancing and getting more freedom. So
and even with that market share, Jarvis was
bad. No, I know that's the scary part about the Jarvis argument.
Now I've got to add, I should have done this for James White. But Brooks, what format is the ADP? Because Jarvis, it's always going to make a big difference.
ADP and rankings are both half PPR.
Okay.
So my thought on average draft position for Jarvis, I have him the highest at 30. I'm guessing that Jarvis Landry is going in the fifth round.
I'm gonna guess the beginning of the seventh. I'm gonna go 701. And where did I split the difference?
Where did
you go in sixth round?
Yeah, I'm gonna go.
Where's he at, Brooks?
Fifth round, 505.
Gross. Why did
he's going off the board as the wide receiver 22? So according to all of our rankings, he's pretty overdrafted right now.
Yeah, I would not touch him there. I mean, you've got a player who's not a touchdown machine. He has always needed to have volume to be. I mean, he's great. And he's going to be great for the Browns, but from a fantasy standpoint, he's not the one. He's not even going to be close to the one when it comes to targets.
He's not Neo.
It's not going to be like 135 to 125 targets between Odell Beckham and Jarvis Landry. Odell Beckham's going to be, 150 and to 120, 115. And if you're working close to the line of scrimmage like Jarvis does, you don't get the touchdowns.
I was actually going to bring that up. His average per reception did go up last year from 8.8 to 12 in Cleveland. His receptions took a precipitous drop from 112 down to 81,
but my
about
point
the
is
same yardage.
He's not going to be doing that with Odell Beckham there. That's, you know what I mean? Like him being the guy down the field, that's they
what
were using
fantasy
him the way that they're going to use Odell Beckham this season.
I would imagine a very similar season for Jarvis Landry.
Well, one that you were disappointed in because the thing
81
is,
for 950 and 4? I mean,
he was wide receiver 19 and a half point.
So
he was wide receiver 19 and a half point, but if you look at how he got there, the percentage of good weeks versus bad weeks, I think he had a couple monster games. I'll look that up, but I don't remember people being happy owning Jarvis last year.
I think he's interesting, though, because now his draft position right now, it doesn't reflect a discount for Beckham arriving, right?
Right.
So that,
well,
that
I mean, I guess a
like Jason,
bit.
You thought he was a seventh four. Round pick, and you didn't even sound happy.
Right.
I would have been super happy with Jarvis as a seventh round
I'll
pick.
I'll consider him in the seventh.
Get Zooks! You made it to the end of the video. Congratulations. If you want to see more, click that subscribe button.